What's going on, gamers? Today, we're going to go over how to make a CSGO server.
Bomb has been planted.
Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Counter-Strike Global Offensive servers offer a customizable experience for you and your friends to enjoy, adding things like downloadable plugins, workshop mods, and other available configurations. These truly give you total control over the game and its modes, which is what most server owners want when choosing a game to host. But in order to make these changes, you are of course going to need one thing, a server. Today, we are going to be going over everything you need to know about creating and configuring a CSGO server with Apex. Before we get started, just remember that any links that I mention will all be in the description down below. First, head towards your Apex server panel and scroll down to the game file section. Click on the drop-down menu, and then you're going to look up Counter-Strike Global Offensive, and then you can either choose to press the source mod or the default variant for the game. Source mod is the one that you're going to use if you plan on adding mods into your server. Confirm the changes, and then choose to generate a new world, but don't restart the server just yet. Once you've done that, head to Customizations on the left-hand menu of the main panel. Keep this tab open, and then you can head towards Steam's Server Management area. Sign into your Steam account, and then find Create a New Game Server Account on this page. Enter 730 for the app ID field, and then anything you want to help you keep track in the memo section. Afterwards, you can press Create and then copy the newly created token. Once you copied it, head back into that customizations page and scroll to find Steam account token. Paste the token in this field and then changes save automatically. So you can click on your server name at the top of the page to head back to the main panel where you can restart the server. To join your new server, you're going to find the IP address port area on the main panel page, copy the numbers, and then open Steam on your computer. Launch CSGO and then head towards the Play category and click Official Matchmaking and change it to Community Server Browser. From here, you can press Add a Server in the bottom right corner and then paste the IP address and port numbers into the text box. Afterwards, just click Add this address to favorites to easily find it. Once you're done, you can select your server in the favorites list and then press connect near the bottom. So now that you have your new server, you're going to want to edit and tailor the experience to your liking. These are all found in the customizations menu, so I'm going to go over all of them at once. Just remember that anytime you make changes in the customization menu, you will have to restart the server for those changes to take effect. To create a server name, head into that customizations area from the server panel and find server settings. Inside of this category, find the host name option and then enter your desired server name here. There are three methods for changing the maps, which include the voting system, server console, and startup options, which is the one that we're going to be going over today. Scroll down to the bottom of the customizations page and find the map setting, and then you can enter the desired map code in the text field, which can be found in the link in the description. When you're looking through that page and looking for a map, the internal VSP name is the code that you're going to be looking for. Just like changing maps, there are also multiple methods to enable cheats. In that customizations page, find Allow Cheats under Server Settings and then checkmark the option. After that, head back to the main panel and restart the server to apply the changes. Once the server goes online, launch CSGO from Steam and head to Settings, and then inside this menu, click the Game category and find Enable Developer Console. Make sure this setting is changed to Yes in the drop-down section, and then you can join your server. This will now give you the ability to use the tilde keybind to open the console for cheat commands. On the topic of commands, here are some of the best ones that you could use on the server, but of course, with any game, there are a lot more that will be linked in our guide. head towards the Source Mod Plugins page and then use the search options to find a plugin that you want to use. Once you find it, click on it and find a download link or press the Get Plugin button near the bottom. Save the files in an easily accessible location on your computer for later. Afterwards, you can head to your Apex panel and stop the server, and make sure you're running the Counter-Strike Global Offensive Source Mod option before you continue. Enter into the FTP file access in the top left, and then you're going to want to enter CSGO, Add-ons, and then Source Mod. Create or find the plugins folder, and then enter it and press Upload in the top left. On the next page, drag and drop all of the files into the upload area and wait for them to reach 100%. Once everything's uploaded completely, you can head back into the main panel page and restart the server. If you're wanting a custom workshop map, then you're going to want to head to CSGO's workshop page and find the map that you want from the search options. Next, click on its page and copy the numbers at the end of the URL. After copying the ID, head towards your Apex server panel and enter into customizations like before, and then find the workshop file ID option and paste the map's ID into the text field. Once that's done, do like you've done before and head back to the main panel and restart the server. Once you have the CSGO server set up, everything else that comes after is up to you and what you're looking for in your gameplay. With as many options as there are for mods, workshop maps, and customizations, you could honestly spend hours tweaking settings and adding maps to get the exact game that you want. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.